Hello, my lovely students, my lovely atoms. I am back. Your Anubha ma'am is back with the one more power pack session. Why? Because this is VIP series called as very important problem series where we discuss all the possible type of subjective questions which are important for your exam point of view. So students, today the topic will be analytical chemistry. Chapter is not difficult at all, but there are so many things that you need to keep in your mind. So we'll do each and every important questions in a detailed solution manner, and the topic will be action of sodium hydroxide, a strong alkali, and ammonium hydroxide, which is a weak alkali, on different metal salt solution, and action of alkali on metals and metal oxides as well. So as I said, please stay till the end and revise all the questions with me. You can have a notebook and pen, because when you'll solve it on your own and you'll realize where you are making mistakes, you can definitely correct it, because still there is time left. I hope you know already that exam date sheet is already out and you're having your chemistry exam on 31st May. So now you know the target, you know the goal, what you have to achieve when you have your exam, so you can plan it properly. So please revise with the help of VIP series, Umang series, then we have one shot videos, we have the entire sprint, which is super 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 important. So you don't have to go anywhere. There's only one place called as Vedantu 19 channel, where you get all the possible content and all the videos. So stay tuned, students, and don't forget to like the video. Please share it among your friends and definitely subscribe if you're new. And let's start with the very first question. Let's see what exactly it says. So students, question number one is a very basic definition that you should know from this chapter. That is, what do you understand by the following terms? What exactly is analysis, qualitative analysis, reagent and precipitation? So students, when I talk about analysis, that is of two types, and that came with qualitative and quantitative analysis. Analysis is exactly what? You are getting this word, right? Something to analyze. And what basically we are analyzing, this is something in which we analyze what exactly are my components there in a particular substance, and then to identify them. So to know about all the components, to know exactly about their nature, to know what exactly is their composition, that we do when we talk about analysis. And qualitative analysis is definitely, I'm talking about what do we need to observe in qualitative analysis. We're going to identify the unknown substance. Whenever we used to go to organic chemistry laboratory, I still remember my master's days, and my teachers used to give a mixture of compounds to us, organic compounds, like just do the qualitative analysis. Means we needed to identify all the compounds that was there with the help of some of the chemical tests. So that came under the qualitative analysis, where we are determining the unknown substance that's there with the help of the required test. So that is what it is. Okay, students, what exactly is reagent? Reagent is something that participates in a chemical reaction, and at the end we can get it back also. So this is acting as a reagent which we use in a chemical reaction, going to react with certain substances, and at the end, even after reacting, it will come out as a product and we can have it back, which is like amazing, best part of chemistry sometimes we see. Can you please tell me any reaction in which we use any substance as reagent? That's there in my mind, but I just wanted to know your response in the comment section, that how active my students are, okay, and how much chemistry is there. precipitation reaction, if I talk about, is one kind of a reaction where you get one of the product as insoluble substance that settles down at the bottom of your test tube when you perform it. So especially that is example of DD reaction only, double displacement or double decomposition, where you're going to mix two aqueous solution and one of the substance settles down as an insoluble product called as precipitate, and the reaction will be precipitation reaction, because you're getting one substance as precipitate. So easy peasy. Hope you got it. These definitions were important. Okay, let's move to question number two, which says, what are the use of sodium and ammonium hydroxide in analytical chemistry? Come on, students. This, you know, that is a strong alkali. If I talk about my ammonium hydroxide, that is a weak alkali. And why do we use this strong and weak alkali in analytical chemistry? Because these are the ones with the help of which we can analyze so many things. We can identify the metal ions present in my sample. So to identify the metal ions, we generally use these strong and weak alkalis, and by different set of reactions, we can make a difference between them, that this is this metal ion, this is this metal ion, because with alkali, they'll give insoluble metal hydroxides, and by knowing those precipitate, knowing their color and composition, we can get to know so many details. So I think this is difficult, is it? I don't think so, because this is something that we did in so many sessions already, again and again, again and again. So this is something we are having a revision, and revision must be super solid. So make your base super solid, and then only the building will be stronger. And then only you'll be able to score good marks, because your concepts are super, super clear. Okay, so this is something, you got it, that we use in analytical chemistry, because those metal ions will precipitate out in form of metal hydroxide, and we can identify them. Simple, yes. Let's see question number 3. A good question. Out of the following metal ions, I'm having aluminium ions, calcium ions, copper ion, lead ion, and zinc ion. Which one form a white hydroxide which dissolves in an axis of either aqueous NaOH or ammonium hydroxide? Okay, this is a very good question. Now, students generally confuse between aluminium ion, because they say that, ma'am, aluminium is an amphoteric metal. When I talk about its ion, they can, whenever you take this and put it into NaOH, what will happen? They'll give not a precipitate, there is something they'll give a salt which is soluble in water. So this is something not possible. When I talk about the other ions, the problem is this, that it's written that in axis they must be dissolved. Calcium ion in axis, it won't be dissolved. But when I talk about zinc ion, copper ion possible to dissolve in axis of ammonium hydroxide, but they won't give a white hydroxide. They'll give copper hydroxide, which is of blue color. But you know that zinc is the one that can give zinc hydroxide, which is of white color. So the reaction will be, let me tell you, suppose I have taken zinc chloride. You can take zinc sulfate also, zinc plus 2. I've taken a compound of zinc with plus 2 charge. I put it into ammonium hydroxide. You know what will be formed? Zinc hydroxide, right? DD reaction, this will go with this, this will this. And with two molecule of ammonium chloride. Simple. This is white precipitate we got. If you take lead, that is something in solution, they'll give a salt that is soluble, because this is amphoteric in nature, so as aluminium. No white precipitate at all. Copper, if I talk about, sorry, calcium, it won't be dissolved in excess of solution. Copper will give you a blue color precipitate. So all of these were not following the data. But when I talk about this, we got white precipitate, and when we put excess of ammonium hydroxide again, they'll make a coordination complex that is soluble, a colorless complex. So zinc with 2NH4, it will take 4 molecule of ammonia, make a complex, and with 2 chlorine, Cl2. This is my complex we got. What do we call it? Tetraamine zinc chloride. Okay. And apart from that, we had 2OH and 2OH, 4OH, and from 4NH4, we used 4NH3, 4 hydrogen is still there. So 4 hydrogen were left and 4OH were left. We are having 4 molecule of water too. So this is we got, this is my soluble complex we got. So basically the correct answer is what? That is my zinc plus 2 ion. Okay, so this is the right answer. I hope you understood it properly, because these reactions you should keep in mind. Please do remember that when I talk about my D block elements, that is copper and zinc, these are the one that's soluble in excess of ammonium hydroxide to give soluble complexes. This is an important question. Okay, students, so let's move to next question. Anytime, whenever you see the description box, there's already the file attached in the form of PDF where you can see the entire solution also, and you can access this anytime you like. Let me have a quick revision with the help of the question practice, so you can do that by downloading the PDF. Let's have the next question, students. This is my personal favorite, because you're like, ma'am, why do they play so much with the colors? This is something interesting. I've made a special video on the color of compounds. Please check that out as well. Write the probable color of the following salts. Ferrous and ferric are two different. When we use us for my lower valency and ic for higher valency. So ferrous is Fe plus 2. This is my ammonium salt, means ammonium in the +3 form, cupric and then cuprous. Cupric, higher valency, so copper +2. Calcium salt and aluminium. Okay, this is ammonium salt, NH4 positive. And this is aluminium salt. Probable color of the following salt. So, if I talk about ferrous salt, Fe plus 2 give a dirty green color. Okay. And ammonium salts are basically colorless. Ammonium chloride, you can say white color as well. Okay. When I talk about cupric salt, +2, copper hydroxide, suppose one of the example, pale blue color. When I talk about calcium, white. Again, no color, like generally white colored salt. And aluminium, again, but white, but what kind of a white? Gelatinous white. Okay, so aluminium give gelatinous white color. Please do check out that video also. Some fun mnemonics we use to remember the color of the ions. This is important, the base of this chapter, and must be super clear. Okay, colorless means they are talking about the white only, so please do remember that. Which reagent can be used to distinguish a solution containing a lead salt and containing a zinc salt? As I said, whenever it talks about zinc ion and copper ion, always choose ammonium hydroxide, because your zinc or copper ion is going to be soluble in excess of ammonium hydroxide. So if you remember, if I'm going to take ammonium hydroxide, first it will give us zinc hydroxide and ammonium salt. Suppose I'm taking Cl2, as we had taken, so ammonium chloride. We got this white precipitate that is going to be soluble in excess of ammonium hydroxide, right? We already did this reaction, but lead ion will not do the same. So please do remember that we can use my ammonium hydroxide to identify the same. Give me a high five. You got this properly. Thumbs up. That will also work. Comment section will also work. Yes, ma'am. We got it properly. Okay, students, we'll move ahead now. But I really want to tell you about this platform called as Vedantu, that how right now also you can plan your study strategically, because 31st May is your exam. 2 to 3 months are left. Basically, we'll talk about 2 months, and there will be crash courses for this 2 months in a very low price, and you can revise all the topics and can measure where exactly is your preparation, where you need to put more and more attention with all the facilities that Vedantu is providing in terms of giving you unlimited live classes. You can plan accordingly that when you're free and can see the session. With so much of quizzes in each and every session, with the topic clarity, there will be quizzes. Topic and then quiz. Topic quizzes to know from you guys that how much you got it and can revise accordingly. A teacher will do the job. And you will be able to have a healthy competition with the students throughout the world, because you guys will play in the quizzes. Your name will come to the leaderboard. The best part is, as I said, you can see the session anytime in the replay mode also. And you can have your live quizzes in the replay too. Isn't it great? How's that possible? When you see the replay, you will see that at the time of quizzes, you will be able to participate and can make sure that this will also give you a live experience, which is not happening anywhere else. So please make sure to come here and have all the sessions in a wonderful manner and ensure that you're getting everything. You'll be able to get the notes of each and every session too, with our own feedback, teacher's feedback. This is important. From this topic, a question will come from this marks and so on. So all the feedback will be there, so that whenever you'll download, you can revise it anytime with the, detailed analysis. And as I said, all of your doubts will be solved with the help of master teachers and a team of class teachers totally dedicated to solve your doubts. So no doubt will be smaller or bigger. Every doubt is important and should be cleared. That's what we believe. With so much of free courses. So this is not done, students. There is so much we have to offer apart from that. That is, as I said, 2 month kind of a crash courses we are going to launch, where with that course you can revise each and everything and can make sure that at least you can see 10 to 15% growth in your performance. So that can only happen in a very, very less price. You will get more and more facilities, because we do believe that we wanted to be with you and we are with you. So there will be a 50% discount right now that is going on. The link is there in the description box, also pinned by Vedantu 19 channel, which will be the very first message you see in the comment section, chat section. That will be the link for pro classes. Click on that, select ICSC 10th class, select your crash courses, your quick revision courses by choosing 1 month, 2 month courses, and do not forget to apply this AGE. AGE, ma'am's code is AGE Pro. AGE is Pro. Okay, that will give you that 50% discount only. And the course for 1 month for ICSE is for 269 and before. But right now it's 1349.5 with 50% discount of the teacher code. And it's like you're having a session in as low as 6 rupees. And even in a 1 month, you can plan your study properly and can revise all the topics which you really wanted and was troublesome for you. In a price lesser than a pari pack. Maybe whatever snacks you like. Okay, so that's definitely possible at this platform. Please do not forget it. And let's see some more questions, because more and more practice, you will do good, because you came across with plenty of questions, different type of questions. If nothing is left, what will examiner give you? Yeah, you're like super prepared already. Okay, question number 6 said, state the color of the precipitate observed when caustic soda solution is added to the following solution. I hope you're pretty much clear that caustic soda is nothing but sodium hydroxide aqueous solution, right, in water. So the first part is, I had copper sulfate and when I put it into ammonium hydroxide, again, you do not need to write all the equation. They're just talking about the color of precipitate. Please remember, when I talk about copper, double displacement, copper hydroxide, my copper plus two ions are the one that give pale blue color. I hope you remember, we somehow discussed this kind of a question. Ferrous is Fe plus two. So ferrous hydroxide, whenever I got dirty green color, right? And when I talk about my ferric Fe plus 3, that will give reddish brown color. Okay, reddish brown color. When I talk about lead nitrate, means I'm having lead ion, colorless, or you can say white color precipitate. That's what colorless is, precipitate. Calcium chloride will again give you white precipitate. And when I talk about zinc, lead ko, you can also say chalky white precipitate. And zinc sulfate, again, white precipitate. Okay, gelatinous white kind of. So this is something that, yeah, white is also having different types. You might have not knew that before, but yeah, this is happening. And that was like, for me also, it's like, yeah, this is happening. What? Okay. Question number 7 is this, and this is very much important question regarding amphoteric nature of your metal and its oxide and hydroxide. What exactly is amphoteric metal? Ampho comes from a word, amphi means dual behavior. So amphoteric metals are those kind of a metal which can not only donate its electron and show basic behavior, can also accept electrons sometime and can be acidic as well. Lewis said that when metal donate electron, which generally does, when element donate electron, that shows basic behavior. And when they accept electron, they show acidic behavior. So my metal like aluminium, zinc, iron, tin, these are some of the metal that shows amphoteric behavior. They can lose their loosely bounded electron, and due to vacant d orbitals, they can accept those electrons as well. Okay, so these are some of the examples. Describe their reaction with hot caustic alkali, which is my NaOH, and that's what it is there. I'm having, suppose, aluminium, and I'm putting into sodium hydroxide hot concentrated solution. I took NaOH, I put water into it, I put aluminium pieces in that hot solution. I have made it hot. Reaction will happen, and we'll get salt and hydrogen gas. Metal with acid gives generally salt and hydrogen gas. Same reaction will happen when I take my metal, that is my amphoteric metal, with my base, I'll get salt and hydrogen gas as well. So there are some examples. Sodium aluminate, I got potassium aluminate salt along with hydrogen gas. With my tin, I got my potassium stannate. Stannum is your metal with hydrogen gas, which you can detect with a pop sound too. Okay, so this makes sense and easy also. But yeah, you have to focus on reactions and its balancing as well, because teacher will be impressed that you know it properly and will give you full marks. What are amphoteric oxides? Why these oxides react with NaOH? Again, amphoteric oxides are those oxides of metal only which can react with acids as well as bases. Why these oxides react with NaOH? Because they can behave as basic substances also, and by reacting with NaOH, they'll give you salt and water. We can do one reaction for sure. Suppose I'm talking about my zinc oxide, which is amphoteric. Whenever we put it into sodium hydroxide, it's like base and acid react together. If that is a base, it behaves like acidic, and that gives salt and water. So we will get sodium zincate, okay? And apart from that, I'm going to get water, H2O. That's what is left. So please remember that. This is quite like good question, I must say. And let's move to next question now, students. Next question is, how will you distinguish between the following pairs of compound? Again, with the help of our caustic soda and my weak alkali, which is ammonium hydroxide, we can detect that. Let's see that. Zinc nitrate and calcium nitrate solution. So I have zinc nitrate solution and calcium nitrate. If I take ammonium hydroxide, students, ammonium hydroxide generally doesn't react with calcium because it won't precipitate out to give calcium hydroxide solution because of weak nature. So when I take ammonium hydroxide, I must get calcium hydroxide precipitate, but this is a weak alkali, and by reacting with the same, it won't precipitate out because of lacking or I must say less amount of OH anion which it will produce. So with calcium ion, no precipitation, but with zinc, if I take zinc nitrate and put it into my ammonium hydroxide solution, I got zinc hydroxide white precipitate. The other part also, you can say, with axis of alkali, this white precipitate will be soluble. Soluble in axis of alkali. Axis of ammonium hydroxide, basically, which will not be the case in calcium hydroxide. Okay, clear? Let's talk about next part, sodium nitrate and sodium chloride. This is a good question. Sodium is same, so sodium is not doing anything. But when we focus on the next part, that is nitrate solution, and then I'm having chloride solution. If you remember nitrate solution, just to detect nitrate ion, we do a test called as Brown ring test. What's the name of test? Brown ring test. How to detect that? In that sodium nitrate solution, I'm having free nitrate ion. I'm going to put a freshly prepared ferrous sulfate solution. Ferrous sulfate, ferrin in plus 2, that will try to do what? Reduction of my nitrate and itself getting oxidized to Fe plus 2. Ion plus 2 converting to Fe plus 3. Loss of electron oxidation, itself going to oxidize and reduce this and give NO ions. Okay, we are going to get nitrosyl ion here. And finally, that will be going to react with my remaining amount of iron in that water, and I'm going to get a complex like this. I must say coordination complex. Fe reacting with my water molecule and NO and giving an octahedral complex. 6 bond formation it's making around it. And this substance is something that will give you a brown color ring whenever you put excess of sulfuric acid of high density. So you take my sodium nitrate, you put ferrous sulfate, freshly prepared solution, mix it. And as soon as you're going to put sulfuric acid, high density substance, that will settle down, the solution will come upward, and in between that, there will be a brown ring formation there. So that's a property of nitrate solution, but not going to happen in sodium chloride. So you can simply say brown ring test will work here. Okay. Let's see the next part, iron chloride solution and copper chloride. This is very easy, iron plus 3. If I talk about iron plus 3, I can take one more slide. Okay. If I talk about iron plus 3 is the one that gives reddish brown precipitate. And when I talk about my copper, that will give you a blue color precipitate. So you can see Fe plus 3, reddish brown color with my alkali, because this will give you FeOH thrice. Okay, but when I talk about copper chloride, it will form copper hydroxide with alkali, blue color precipitate. Yes, but see on this part, iron 2 sulfate, iron in plus 2, and that gives a dirty green color, dirty green precipitate. It's hydroxide. Copper sulfate again, blue color precipitate. So with the help of an alkali which we had taken, that is NaOH, or we can take the other one also, we can distinguish among the following. So I think this is easy too, and I think your revision is now going very good, and you're super confident that if these kind of a question will come, you will not hesitate while answering, because you did enough hard work, enough practice with such kind of a questions. Now let's move ahead. There's one more question, and the question is, what do you observe in caustic soda, which is my NaOH, is added to the following? I have added NaOH into FeCl3, my ferric chloride solution and my aluminium sulfate, and we have to write its balanced chemical equation. I have taken ferric chloride aqueous solution because these are kind of a DT reaction only. with three NaOH because Fe has to be taken by three OH because to justify the valency. I got FeOH thrice solution, which is my reddish brown precipitate. So solid, you'll write in bracket. Okay, reddish brown. And apart from that, my 3Na with 3Cl, I got 3 molecule of NaCl. Aqueous, because that will be soluble in water. Make sense? Got it? Let's talk about the next part where I have taken aluminium sulfate and I am going to put it into NaOH. So NaOH, how much NaOH we'll be needing? Let's see, depending on the product. Aluminium with OH will give aluminium hydroxide. So 2 aluminium, so I'll write 2 here. So I'll be needing 6 OH, so I'll write 6 here. So 2 AlOH thrice, I got solid, and that is gelatinous white precipitate, 6 Na. And if I write in this way, 3 Na2SO4, because sodium with sulfate will give you sodium sulfate. 6 Na and 3 sulfate, the reaction is balanced, and that is aqueous, that will be soluble in water. Sodium sulfate soluble in water, and the precipitate of aluminium hydroxide is going to settle down. So we wrote the balance equation as well. I hope you got it. That was not at all difficult. I think you can do it easily. Yes, students. And what are we going to do next? Something that is important, and that is homework. And I really appreciate when you give all the efforts by answering it properly in the comment section. So I'll wait for it, students. Your question for this class is, what happened? Now we are taking ammonia solution, that is ammonium hydroxide, and we are going to add it drop by drop in excess of copper sulfate, zinc sulfate, the kind of reaction we did, that in copper ion and zinc ion, that will be soluble in excess of alkali and give a water soluble coordination complex. And with FeCl3, that's very simple. Ferric hydroxide, that is what you're going to get, and reddish brown color precipitate. So just give the reaction of all these three. I hope you'll give it. I'll wait for it. And please do let me know in the comment section that hopefully you like the session. I'll wait for your comments. And do remember that we all are there with you. And you can have all the classes of Vedantu platform also at 50% discount right now with the code AGEPRO. So just come and revise in this 1 to 2 months and make sure that no topic will be difficult for you, and you're mastering each and every topic and can easily score 90-95%. Set your goal high and you'll be able to achieve it with all the hard work. Okay, and you can have all the session in as low as 6 rupees per session, because the price dropped to 1349 rupees per month, which was not happening before. So please take a note of it and come and have all the sessions. Okay, students. So you can follow me also on Instagram, chemistry.vedantu_anubhagaur, for all the updates. I generally try to put it over there and try to give all the possible information regarding chemistry to Anna Anubha ma'am as well. Okay. Thank you so much, students, for staying till the last. That is a great time that I had with all of you. Don't forget to like the video. Please share it among your friends. Please subscribe to the channel if you're new. You can reach out to me on my email ID also. And I'll come up with one more session very soon. Please follow VIP series. Tell your friends also to follow for your proper revision. So thank you so much, students. Stay tuned. Hasta la vista. We'll meet next time. Happy learning.